Cue the dramatic music, because today we're talking about rotoscoping in After Effects.
Rotoscoping!
Why the dramatic music? Because any visual effects artist will tell you that rotoscoping is one of the most monotonous tasks that you can have, but the results are timeless. Rotoscoping is the process of masking an object, typically a person, so you can isolate them from the rest of the footage. This lets you apply effects directly to the subject, change the background behind them, or even place them into a completely different scene, similar to what you'd be able to achieve with a green screen. In this video, we'll show you processes for rotoscoping using the pen tool and the Roto Brush. First, let's cover rotoscoping using the pen tool. With your After Effects composition ready, select the pen tool and make sure your footage layer is selected. Then, go to the preview window and start tracing around your subject. Each click adds a point, which then forms a path. Keep a short distance between points to help the mask move better with the subject. In this example, we've now gotten to the shoulder, and since straight lines won't follow the curve of the shoulder well, click and drag to make a Bezier curve. The longer you drag, the smoother the curve. Keep doing this around the entire subject. If you make a mistake, that's fine. You can go back to fix it later. Once you're done, connect the last point to the first to close your mask. If the mask isn't perfect, or you want to fix mistakes, you can rearrange points by clicking them and dragging to a new position. If an area needs an additional point, simply hover over the path line and click. To remove a point, hold Ctrl or Command if you're on a Mac, and click when the icon turns to a minus. To curve an existing point, hold Alt or Option if you're on a Mac to change it to a Bezier point. You can also soften a mask if needed. Select the layer, press F to open feather settings, and increase the setting slightly. Like I mentioned at the beginning, this is a very monotonous process. That was just one frame out of the 24 for a single second. And if it's a 10 second shot, then that's 240 frames that you have to individually rotoscope. When there's a lot of movement, especially with people, managing all of the points around a subject can be difficult. For example, if limbs cross over each other, it's easy to break parts of the mask by mistake. A smarter technique is to separate the body into parts and mask them individually. For example, mask the arms, torso, and head separately. This gives you more control and makes it easier to adjust each area. You can take this level of detail as far as you need, even masking individual fingers if it's helpful for your workflow. With that in mind, let's get on to the next step, which is adding an animation to the mask path. Open the drop-down menu on the footage layer. Select Masks, Mask Path, and create a keyframe by clicking the stopwatch icon next to the mask path setting. Then, press page down on your keyboard to move one frame forward. Even the tiniest movements require slight adjustments to multiple points. So now's the time to pull up a podcast, maybe brew some coffee, and get to work. You're definitely gonna be here a while. This is the final result, a clean rotoscope.
The Masters Tournament returns this week. See you on the green.
Using the original footage as a background layer allows us to place our text between the golfer and the background, making it appear behind the golfer. This is precisely why green and blue screens are so widely used. They eliminate the need for manual rotoscoping. Instead, you can simply key out the green or blue background. When your subject is relatively stationary, with little arm movement and no objects passing in front, like this shot, manual rotoscoping often isn't necessary. Instead, you can use After Effects' AI-powered Roto Brush tool, which can handle most of the work for you. Let's break down how it works. The Roto Brush is used in the layer window. Double-click your layer to open this preview. Then, select the Roto Brush tool or press Alt-W. To adjust the size of your brush, hold Ctrl and drag up or down to increase or decrease the size. Now, all you need to do is paint over a small part of your subject. The tool uses pixel data to guess the edges, and it's usually pretty accurate. After checking the edges on this example, it made a mistake near the head. So, we'll shrink the brush and switch to a minus stroke by holding Alt, which tells After Effects to exclude it from the mask. Then, paint over the part we want to remove. If your subject moves their arm away from their body, creating a gap between the torso and arm, After Effects usually automatically detects this and excludes that area from the mask. If it doesn't, go to that point in the timeline, hold Alt to bring up the minus brush, and simply paint within that area. That way, you're giving After Effects additional information about what to exclude. When you press play, After Effects propagates the Roto Brush, meaning that it's masking out the other frames based on information provided. If you toggle back to the composition window, the Roto Brush has done a decent job in about 90% less time than manual rotoscoping. However, if you look closely, there are some small edge issues here. Thankfully, there's a few settings in the effects controls that you can tweak to fix that. The main settings here, feather, contrast, shift edge, and reduce chatter are shown by default. That's primarily because adjusting these settings provides the best improvements. How exactly you adjust them is dependent on the specific video clip. If the Roto Brush still didn't do a great job, double-click the layer to return to the layer view, then double-press Alt-W to bring up the Refine Edge tool. You can see if it's active because the Roto Brush tool switches to this icon. Now, go along the edges, especially around hair or fabric, to tell After Effects to refine this edge. Once that's complete, this is the final result. While it's not inherently glamorous, rotoscoping remains an incredibly important skill in the visual effects industry. Without a green screen, you're just not going to achieve that level of masking from an AI tool. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Then, head over to storyblocks.com for unlimited downloads of royalty-free green screen footage that you won't need to rotoscope manually, templates, music, and more.